love one another. But make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together, and be joyous. But let each one of you be alone, even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping. For only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart. And the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow.
Of you run through my head every time that I'm near you. I realize that you're heaven sent.
Come on.
Oh, I think you're truly something special. Just what my dreams are really made of. Let's stay together, you and me, girl. There's no one like you around, around.
There's nobody like you.
No.
Hey, why don't we pray together? Father in heaven, I'm so grateful for the opportunity to celebrate this union together. And God, as we come together in laughter and in joy, we're so grateful that you and your sovereignty brought together Brian and Kayla. And so God, I pray that today you are honored and glorified in everything that happens here. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Well, we've gathered together in the presence of God for a holy service of worship. And so let all those who are gathered together here call themselves to the worship of the Most High God, for this is His ceremony, and marriage is His institution. And today, we've come to celebrate and witness the holy matrimony of Brian Lewis to Kayla Viad. Kayla, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
Brian, you clean up nice. Kayla, this is a day that you've been waiting for a long time. You probably dreamed about this since you were a little girl. And dads, this is a day that we remember that little girls grow up. Today I have with me my little girl. And I'm sure that when Kayla was a little girl, you probably brought her to events like this. And now, it's your turn, Simon. And it's important for Brian and Kayla that they be married by a pastor under the authority of a church. This is not simply a civil union between a man and a woman. This is a Christian marriage between a Christian man and a Christian woman. And so the vows that are shared here today, they're not just a promise to the state of Florida. These are a promise to the God of the universe. And so, being assured that this couple understands the commitment that they're making today to the Lord and to each other, let me ask you this question, Simon. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Well, Brian, Kayla, this is the day that you've been waiting for a long time. And after all the planning, after the flowers and the matching outfits, and even getting through a hurricane this week, we finally made it. And we're here. And this is a day that marks the official legal union of your two families. And I'm so proud of both of you. I'm proud of the ways that you have worked hard to honor your parents. I'm proud of the ways that you've worked hard to honor each other. And most importantly, I'm proud of the ways that you've worked hard to honor the Lord. Kayla, I've had the privilege of watching you grow and develop in the Lord for a very long time. I remember you as a college student taking you to the Passion Conference and watching your faith just continue to grow and develop. I've watched you serve here in our church, mature in your faith, and become such a great Christian leader here in our church. And Brian, you and I haven't known each other as long, but I do remember how important it was to Kayla that when you first started dating, she had to introduce you to me. And that was a really big, big deal. And I love hearing about your Christian conviction and your work ethic and your desire to make Christ first in everything. Just a few minutes before we started here tonight, I asked Kayla, "Kayla, what makes Brian perfect for you?" And she said, "He is so consistent in his love for me." And I believe that's going to be the case all throughout your marriage relationship. And I promise that if you'll keep Christ first, there's really no limit to what God can do with this relationship. The act of marriage is as ancient as the human race itself, beginning all the way back in Genesis chapter 2. When we search the scriptures, we see that God highly values marriage. In Genesis chapter 2, we see that Adam was alone in the garden, and in verse 18, the Bible says, "Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him.' So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, 'This at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man.'" This verse is poetic. It's breathtaking. Adam's breath is literally taken away, almost like yours was when you just saw your bride come down the stairs. The verse goes on to say, "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." And this is God's template for marriage: leaving and cleaving. One man, one woman, male, female, husband, wife, being fruitful and multiplying, taking dominion. God speaks of marriage all through the scriptures. In Proverbs chapter 18, the Bible says, "He who finds a wife finds a good thing." Brian, you have found a very good thing. Amen. In Mark chapter 15, Jesus is speaking of marriage, and he says that this is a relationship that's so strong that what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. In Revelation chapter 19, the Bible says that Jesus is going to return one day for his church. And Jesus so closely associates his relationship with the church that he calls the church his bride. You see, marriage is such a big deal, and it's all throughout the scriptures. It's this institution which is the keystone of all human society. It's more central to human life than the state and any other human institution. This decision is more important than the decision of where you work. It's more important than the decision of how you vote. It's more important than any other decision that you could ever make other than choosing to follow Christ. This is the most important decision you could ever make. The family, as God's ordained cornerstone, is the bonding of a man and a woman for as long as they shall live, and with whatever children the Lord shall bless. The family is to be the first government, the first school, and the first church. Brian and Kayla are standing here giving testimony that they believe that it is the sovereign will of the God of the universe that they be united in the bonds of marriage. And so, in order to symbolize their love and servitude for each other, Brian and Kayla would like to wash each other's feet. Now, you may be familiar with the idea of foot washing from the New Testament. On the night that Jesus was having the Last Supper with his disciples, he washed the disciples' feet. Jesus, the God of the universe, took the place of a servant to show his love for his people. At Family Church, we believe in submission and headship, but we also believe in fundamental equality, between men and women. As human beings, we believe that we're all equal. Every person from every place, every neighborhood, and every race. Marriage is a partnership of mutual submission. By washing each other's feet today, you're saying, I not only stand before you promising my love with a vow and a ring, but I'm kneeling before you washing your feet, humbly accepting you as you are, not only with my words, but with my actions. My love is not just a promise, but an unconditional action of love.
You make all things beautiful, beautiful for me. 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 So I am not moved by what I see. He's seen it all. He's gone before me. I am not moved by what I feel. He knows it all.
It's so beautiful to think about how you want this relationship to really be grounded on the idea of serving one another. And if you'll truly take that posture and truly serve one another, I promise you, this will be a fun relationship. We're going to share some vows, and Brian, Kayla, you've chosen to write your own vows to each other. And so we're going to repeat the traditional vows, but before we do, Brian, why don't you start by sharing your vows with Kayla?
I'm going to be honest, I was very nervous and rewrote these maybe 5 or 6 times. So, Kayla, I love you so much. I'm truly thankful for what the Lord has done in our lives. I also am thankful that He brought you into my life. You're a woman that is kind and gracious, someone that is never afraid to speak her mind, and a woman that loves with all of her heart and is completely selfless. And most importantly, a woman who loves the Lord and always puts the Lord's will first. Mm. Kayla, I promise to love you. I promise to love you and lead our house with grace and love, and to always try to follow where the Lord leads us.
Yeah. And Kayla? We live in a digital age.
In the past 3 years, we've experienced a global pandemic, a recession, losing our pets, jobs, and lots of other stressors, and now a hurricane right before our wedding. But your character has just remained true and consistent. You've also experienced so many highs, like baptisms, birthdays, traveling together, starting a business, and just growing closer to each other in the Lord. I know that you're the man God has for me because you have so many qualities that I didn't know I needed in a partner. God in His sovereignty brought you into my life. So I want to say thank you. Thank you for loving me unconditionally with the heart of a servant leader. Thank you for never making me feel like I'm too much and you have the patience of a saint. Thank you for covering me in prayer when anxiety and a whirlwind of emotion set in. Thank you for being an example to Bailey and Maddox and leading our family. I love your adventurous spirit and your spontaneity. You level me out. I may not want to admit it, but I even love your awful dad jokes. All right, now for the vows, guys. I vow to love you when we're old and gray and all your hair falls out. Or...
Too late.
I vow to wake up every morning and thank God that He gave me you. I vow to be honest and faithful all of our days. As your wife, I vow to love you during the mountains and the valleys. Mm. I vow to respect you, encourage you, and most importantly, rub your head when you fall asleep.
Mm. Well, Brian and Kayla, I so appreciate the way that you shared from the heart those vows. And if you're called and willing to enter into this sacred bond and holy covenant, and if you know of no barrier to this union, I want you to signify by your response to these vows by saying, I will. Brian, will you have Kayla to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, keep her in sickness and health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
And Kayla, will you have Brian to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Because of the way that our society has looked at marriage, I want to make sure that everybody fully understands the decision you're making today. So Brian, are you saying in front of me as your pastor, in front of all these witnesses, and most importantly, in front of God in heaven, that you are never going to divorce this woman?
I am.
And Kayla, are you saying in front of me as your pastor, in front of all these friends and family members and witnesses, and most importantly, in front of God in heaven, that you're never going to divorce this man?
I am.
Do we have some rings?
Yes. Thank you.
The ring is universally recognized as a symbol of marriage. It's round, it's a perfect circle representing the eternal bond of marriage. It's a symbol of the lifelong covenant that you're entering. And so Brian, place this ring on your bride's hand and repeat after me. I, Brian, take you, Kayla.
I, Brian, take you, Kayla.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance. Go ahead.
According to God's holy ordinance.
This ring is a symbol of my pledge.
This ring is a single symbol of my pledge.
And Kayla, would you place the ring on your groom's hand and repeat after me? I, Kayla, take you, Brian.
I, Kayla, take you, Brian.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinances.
According to God's holy ordinances.
This ring is a symbol of my pledge.
This ring is a symbol of my pledge.
Well, we've had a Bible study. We've shared some vows. We've exchanged some rings. We've even washed some feet. And so now, Brian, Kayla, you enter into this place with a lot of existing relationships, and those relationships, they don't go away. But now, you have a new relationship, a relationship that is higher than any other earthly relationship. You have been brought together by the sovereign God of the universe, the God who created you, who brought you to life, who redeemed you by the precious blood of his Son. He's now brought you together to be husband and wife. And what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. So, Brian, you may kiss your bride. Brian, Kayla, I have such high hopes for you and what God's going to do in you and through you and what God's going to do in your family. And I want you to remember that you are so loved right here at Family Church. I love you. Our church loves you. But God loves you even more. And as long as you hold on to each other, and as long as you hold on to your calling in the Lord, there's really nothing that God can't do with you.
Amen.
Hey, why don't you go ahead and turn and face your congregation today? Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Brian Lewis.
my time's up, my mind's gone, and I'm flying home, and I'm stressed out, and I'm tempted to get that style phone and go pull it up, but you know what's up, and you know that ain't gonna solve nothing. I mean, Lord forbid, I might fall or something, and I'm all another cushion. So hold me down like death straps in a fight war. Killing me, but you stay with me when I fight hard, and me when I'm eating you. Deal with me when my car's pulled. Could've dealt with me, but you fell for me before I fell for you. Keep me on that right path and the right math. It's you plus nothing's everything. You my everything, same. You ain't gotta question my allegiance, cause the way you love me, I can never leave. I need you.
By my side, thinking thin, highs and lows, don't let go. They love God so much and love their family, Maddox and Bailey. So we're just happy for you and just other's cheerleader, and we pray that your love will abound more and more with each passing year. We love you. Congratulations. Okay, so the next step is my Bible study girls. We've been friends for I don't know how long, but these girls were with me before Ryan came along. They prayed for me, they cried with me, they laughed with me through the ups and downs. They've been there for everything. So I want to let them speak. This is Rodina, Latoya, and Luanda. Make some noise for them.
Well, y'all can keep clapping because that was actually the toast. But we just really wanted to love on you guys. Really, congratulations. We continue to pray and support your union. Through it all, we have gained a brother. And so I'm so excited. And so even though Kayla is a part of our Bible study, we just want to invite you to Brian to let you know that we are here to support you as well, and to support you guys in your union through God, of course. So we love you guys, and we are very excited about what God has for your union. Continue to love each other. Continue to be the mirror image of God's love and grace and mercy. And also just always remember to make sure that you have boundaries so that you guys can be the best for one another. All right, we love you guys.
I remember the first time we met Ryan at the Green Market. Yes. And ever since then, Ryan has just been such a staple, and it's been a blessing to watch your love flourish with one another. And Brian is always like, "Ryan, me, like I'm here." So I just love the consistency of how you show up for Kayla, and how you show up for Eddie as well. So we will be praying for you guys, and we will be loving on you guys, and we will be here every step of the way, from Green Market to
Gray Hair.
Gray hair. Yes.
Just with how she loved you, Ryan. She was very transparent with us and with you all's relationship, which was good. Because if you know Kayla can be a shell, and you'd be like, "Kayla, do you like us or do you not like us?" but for real though, we're excited that this day, I mean, it was very fast, and I'm excited because when you feel like God is showing you, you know, need to waste more time. And so I think that this is a very testimony of what God can do and what He has done. And so I'm excited to spend more time with Ryan. I'm going to spend a lot of time with him, so not just spend time with Ryan. Congratulations, guys, and enjoy the ride.
Talk to me, even when you're not around, I feel you pulling, I feel you pulling, yeah. Tangled in your love.
He made our amazing cake. If you don't know, he's a baker on Facebook and Instagram.
Bring it on, bakery.
BringBakeryPSL.com. Put in your orders today.
Yeah.
So it's just a thrill.
His macaroons are in an ice cream shop in Port St. Lucie called Cool Bean. So if you ever had the macaroons, Brian made it.
Thank you.
Very good.
Okay, so it's a three-layer cake. The top is marble, which none of y'all are getting because we're keeping it. And we're going to eat another one of your anniversary. The middle is lemon with lemon buttercream. And the bottom is red velvet with a cream cheese.
Wow.
She's super. And so we're going to go ahead and cut it.
Even when it's bad, I love you.
Longevity, love on each other, encourage each other, be there for each other. Love y'all. Many, many more. Love you.
So, Brian and Kayla, I wish you the best. I hope that you have a great family. You have all the elements that you need to be able to build something very important with a lot of meaning and beautiful. So, the best wishes from Renee and Padilla family.
Yes, we love you so much. Thank you for inviting us to be part of your big day. We wish you the best. We're so happy to have enjoyed this moment with both of you. We love you so much. Many blessings. We're excited to see what you guys have to do.
Congratulations, Kayla and Brian.
And we just wanted to wish you guys a wonderful union. We are so excited for you guys to be newlyweds, to be life together. Lots of love, blessings, and happiness to come. So, we're just so happy for you all.
Continue your friendship. Let that blossom, let that love and that respect. Just always have that as your foundation of your relationship. And I wish you so much success, prosperity, and happiness. And love you guys.
I am Brian. Oh!
We just want to wish you a happy union and congrats again.
Yep.
And we are so happy to be a part of your story.
Oh my
and your
goodness.
Happily ever after.
Yes.